You did a splendid job. You did a classical detective job in your farm. And I think this case highlights very much two items that are important for BVD control, and that is testing for virus, and quarantine. The same items that are for us humans also today very important with our coronavirus crisis, but you will explain why. Thank you very much.
Okay, Magda, stage is yours. Can you hear us?
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much. if you want to go at the previous one, so I am Magda Sioukiouroglou, and from Cardin in Wales in the UK, somewhere there. And I was planning to say I'm very happy to be part, but now I'm five times happier to be part of this meeting. Thank you very much. And I will present you my case study. So a couple things about me. I studied veterinary medicine at Aristotle University in Thessaloniki in Greece. I'm Greek and graduated in 2015. I worked as a ruminant nutritionist and technical advisor in Greece after that. And then I took the decision to move to the UK. And currently I'm working as a farm animal vet in South Wales for prostock vets. Yeah, we can go on. So a bit of summary, a quick summary of my case report. It is a dairy farm in South Wales, where in 2018 we had one seropositive animal for BVD antibodies. Then the next year in 2019, we had again one animal positive and one animal suspect for BVD antibodies. And in 2020, after a few more testing and research, we can reveal that. We found that she brought the BVD virus into the head from a cattle show when she went in 2018. Thank you. A bit about the background is a 90 cow dairy herd, closed herd. They're not buying in animals. So there's no big risk from that side for the BVD to come in. It's permanently housed as well. There is no nose-to-nose contact with neighboring herds. All year round calving, artificial insemination only used, so we don't have a bull coming into the herd either. And I did say that is a pretty well managed and productive farm. A few things about the history. The farm is relatively new. Was established in 2016 by a Dutch couple. That's why mainly the animals came into the herd from Netherlands, bought in from Netherlands, from non-BVD accredited herds. All the bought in animals were vaccinated with Bovella in 2017, but there was no BVD vaccination onwards after that. Yeah, we can go on. A few things about the Welsh BVD scheme. I'm happy that we had the Irish one, the Northern Irish, and the English one. We've got the Welsh here. It's called Gwaredi BVD, which means in language eradicate BVD. Started in 2017, and all we have to do as the practitioners is to test our head, our bovine heads, for three consecutive years by doing a youngstock screening for BVD antibodies. More detailed, we have to take five blood samples from unvaccinated animals, 9 to 18 mates. And if we find at least one out of these bloods positive, then a PA hand is required and funded. The whole scheme is funded by the Welsh government and EU. Yeah, we can go on. About the BVD testing that already had been done in the past. So in 2017, when the majority of the cows were milking, we took a bulk milk sample for BVD the virus and came back negative. Then in 2018, the last year of the Welsh Gwaredi BVD scheme, and we blood sampled 5 animals for antibodies, and one came back positive. So after that, we decided to take again a milk sample to see if we will find anything. And again, it was negative. What is happening in that farm? Yeah, we can go on. So a few things about our thoughts and possible explanation. So the animals, some of the animals, when they were bought in, they were already pregnant, which means that they could be some of them animals, Trojan heifers or cows, that they could gave birth to a PIA calf. But the size of the farm is relatively small, which means that if we had a calf born, why did we have only one seropositive animal? Or if the calf was there, probably left the farm earlier or died before transmit the virus throughout the head. The last thought, it was that when this animal was already 10 months old, so could that be positive only because it had still maternal antibodies? In the literature, we know that animals, usually they keep the maternal antibodies up to 6 to 9 months. So I don't know if that could be possible. We can go to the next one, thank you. So we had 1 out of 5 seropositive animals. So the head was eligible for the PI hunt, and there was a funding available as well. We decided to do this PI hunt in 2 parts. The first part only for management reasons. The first part happened in July 2019. We tested all the adult animals. We took a bulk milk sample to test the milking heads, and then blood samples for the dry cows and the heifers having calf. Then the second part, in December 2019, during the TB test, we tested the rest of the animals for the virus. And we blood sample all the heifer, the young heifers, and we tagged and test all the baby calves. So all the testing in December 2019 for the virus, you can continue, thank you, came back negative. So great, are we free from BVD? At the same time, thank you, we did the second year of the Guaredi BVD scheme, and we blood sample for antibodies, 2 management groups. The first management group, animals 9 to 12 months of age, all negative. And then the second group, some heifers in calf, we blood sample 5 of them. 1 was positive and 1 suspect. Yeah, we can continue. So again, some question marks. We didn't know what was in a clear head from the virus. We had again some seropositive animals. In order to understand a bit better, we compare the ear tags of the animals that we had tested, and we realized that the suspect animal of 2019 was the same animal was the year before. But what is happening with the new positive animal? So further researching on the British Cattle Movement Service showed out that the positive heifer had been out from the farm for exhibition purposes for a period of 3 months. So you can see her down. She came back into the farm already infected with the virus. And we don't know if she was transiently infected as well, which means that she could have transmitted the virus into a free head to other animals. So maybe the positive and then suspect animal that we had came with her, and that's why we had the 2 animals positive. Yeah, thank you, we can go on. So of course we educated the farmer about the risk of introducing the BVD into his head, and we designed the BVD plan. We decided to tag and test all the cows that will be born this year in 2020 in order to cover all the chances of having a PI born again into the farm. Of course, we advised to the farmer to vaccinate the head again, and of course, animals that he wants to take to cattle so future. And before introducing them back, to keep them in quarantine. And we will keep monitoring annually with 5 blood samples for BVD antibodies. And the next one. So our conclusions are that as practitioners, we need to know the BVD status of our heads and to design a strategy in order to monitor and eradicate the disease. So there is need for detailed health plans. In here is the vaccination as well, biosecurity measures and risk assessment for diseases. And the last one, that's all. Thank you very much and stay safe.